love you. We love you. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
I can't wait to talk about What Was I Made For. I don't even know why it's even in the competition. It is Song of the Year. It is Song of the Year. I'm calling it right now. I'm calling it. Let me just talk about this song for 1 second. It was number one for 14 weeks on the Billboard charts. It streamed over 2 billion times. It's nominated, nominated for a Critics' Choice Award, a Golden Globe, 5 Grammys, including Song of the Year and Record of the Year. Not too shabby. Not too shabby, Billie Eilish. What Was I Made For? I gotta say, I heard the song before I saw the movie, and I listened to it. First of all, hi, how are you?
Hi, Jimmy.
Yeah. and I was like, man, this song is heartbreaking, just beautiful. I loved it so much. And I go, and then I took my kids to go see Barbie, and I'm watching the movie, and I'm waiting for your song. And it wasn't in the movie. And I go, I think it'd be probably after the Ken thing, maybe it'll do that. And I go, no, I go, it's gonna be towards the end. And then when it came on, dude, it knocked me out. Uh-huh. It was the perfect scene, and it's just, it's the end, it's, I was trying to not to cry in front of the whole theater.
Oh, yeah.
I was weeping like a baby. Yeah, it was unbelievably beautiful.
Yeah.
How did it come about? Does Greta Gerwig go, hey, I'm doing a Barbie movie. I want you and Mark Ronson, Phineas, get together, write something?
Well, thanks for all that, first of all. Hi, guys.
Yeah, sorry. Talk for 10 minutes. We're going to go to commercial. We'll be right back with... No, I'm just kidding. I should let you talk.
It's okay. You got a lot to say. It's all good.
Good.
It's your thing. Yeah. So, Greta. So we get like, it was so actually random how this came about. I remember there was like a moment last year where Phineas came to me and he was like, dude, would you want to like make a song for the Barbie movie? And I was like, what kind of a, what? Like, what?
Yeah.
Like, where did that come from? What does that even mean? What would we even make? Like, what's even gonna happen? And then there was like one day in December, Phineas was like, hey, we're gonna get on the phone with Greta Gerwig and Mark Ronson tomorrow. I was like, cool. What? Cool. Love that, super random. Love it.
Yeah.
And we got on it was literally just like a FaceTime. It was super like friendly and casual and cool. And Greta basically just like walked us through the stage they were in and kind of told us about it. And she was like, yeah, if you want to, you know, whatever. And then it kind of just like, you know, we were making music and doing our own stuff and whatever. And there was this one day in January and we went to...
So this is a month later.
A month later.
Yeah.
We went to the studio, like the movie studio.
Yeah.
And it was just me and my brother and Greta and a couple people from her team on this like rainy January night. And we watched like the first 30 minutes of the movie, and then like she showed us like a couple different clips from the movie as well, like the ones she thought were the most important. And you know, she kind of was like, she was like, you don't have to make anything, and if you don't want to make it, right?
Sounds exactly like Greta Gerwig.
I know. But she was like, I don't care, anything you want to make, you can make anything, and if you don't want to make anything, don't make anything, like, please, just like...
That honestly is a great impression of Greta Gerwig. I don't think anyone's done one on this show in the history.
She's so the Greta best. Gerwig.
That's right, she's cool. Like, if you don't want to make it, go ahead, don't
but
make
it's
it.
So sweet. That's cool. She's like she's the sweet... No,
real
yeah,
deal.
Yeah, she is. She's the sweetest person in the world, and she was like, if you're inspired, that's great. If you're not, it's totally fine. And we were like, shut up.
Yeah, we want to do it.
Like, tell us what
tell
you
us what
want
you
us
want
to
for,
do.
Yeah.
And she was like, okay, well, if you don't want to, and we were like, bro, we are good. Like, it's good. This
Let
is
us
good.
Know what's the vibe.
And she was like, well, anything you make, I will be happy with. But if I we were like, what in your perfect world, what are you like missing? What do you want? And she was like, I really want Barbie's heart song. And that like stuck with us. That really,
line.
Yeah, that stayed with us.
Barbie's
and also she had shown us obviously the first like chunk of the movie, but then specific scenes. And one of them was the scene where Barbie and Ruth are in that like white area, the white abyss. And she grabs her hands and she's like, feel. I'm like, it gives me chills when I think about it. And at the time, you know, our song didn't exist and that montage didn't exist either. It was literally like, I don't remember super well, but I think it was just that shot of Margot, which was already so beautiful and like hit me in such a real way. And I just like, it really was burned into my brain. And then like...
They added a scene
they added that montage.
The montage, like, just, you know, from, like, your song.
Yeah, like all the footage of like people living during the song, that was all added
it
after the song.
Crushed me. And yeah. I was like, and also the falsetto, your voice is so good.
Thank you.
But I was like, you are so good. I used to flow. I start crying right there.
Oh, man.
Wait, did you write that first line first and you go,
yeah,
we got this. We have the best opening line for the song. It's so rad.
No, it never feels like that, ever. No, I never am like, yeah, got it. It's always like.
Maybe.
It felt good. I remember, I will say, like, you know, the crazy thing is, and I've told this story a couple times, but it's so special to me to think about, which is like 24 hours after we saw the movie, Phineas and I had this like long day of nothing. Like we had been trying to make stuff and trying to come up with stuff and just could not, like not creative at all, could not think of
writer's
a thing.
Writer's block. That's
total
it.
Just like dud of a day. And then we kind of were like, well, I guess we could take a crack at this, and wrote the entire song in that sitting. And the first thing we wrote was literally Phineas sat at the piano and played that first chord immediately, just like off the dome, just like bling. And I started going da 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 da, and that was like the first.
I'm gonna start. I'm getting emotional right now.
Yeah, man.
But it's got. I mean, I saw in some article you said that it's this song connected. I mean, you've had many hits, but this song connected with fans in a different way.
Yes.
And how is that exactly?
I just felt. First of all, I feel like it brought women together in this way that I feel like I haven't felt part of like that, and it made me feel really good. And I also felt like it was like bringing like people together. It felt like we were all experiencing just like the life experience, you know?
Yeah.
Experiencing experience.
I haven't heard a song like that in so long. It is really a beautiful song. Well
Thank
written,
you.
Well performed. I really love it so much.
Thanks,
congrats
man.
On that. I really excited for that. I'm happy for all the awards and all the recognition you're getting for it. So good. You're back. By the way, you did say that you guys are working on stuff. Does that mean maybe new album? Like digging. I'm going for the scoop. You can tell me. I won't tell anybody. It's your old pal.
It's a secret. It's a secret.
It's
we are almost done with this new album we're working. So.
All right.
At some point, you will know more, but I'm not going to say anything.
All right. Okay. We're building for Saturday Night Live. It's coming up this Saturday. Kate McKinnon is the host.
Yeah.
Who is unbelievable. She was great in Barbie.
Yes.
Do you know what songs you're going to be singing for the show?
I do.
Yeah. And do we know the songs you're going to sing?
I mean, bing.
All right, okay, we will get that?
Uh-huh.
All right, good. I'm very excited, congratulations. We love it when you come by. You're one of my favorites, buddy. Awesome song. Billie Eilish, What Was I Made For is streaming now. You can see Billie perform on Saturday Night Live this weekend with host Kate McKinnon. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey.